It's easy to sing after the Lord fulfills in your life miracles that he promised to you. But oh, Mary sang before Jesus was born. He said, I believe the promise of God. So whatever God promised you, believe that the Bible says that the world will pass away, but his promises never will. God will tell a miracle.
He's Emmanuel. The angel Gabriel, and the moment when he came to Mary, he came to this young woman of God and gave her a promise from God that she will have a son and that he will be great, the son of the Most High God, and she's supposed to call his name Jesus. 6 months before this, the same angel came to another man of God named Zechariah and gave him the same message. He said, you're gonna have a son, and he will also be great, and you are to call his name John, and we're talking here about John the Baptist and Zechariah, his father. Now, there are many interesting things about these two stories. The same angel Gabriel comes to both Mary and Zechariah. The same angel Gabriel give them the same message that they're gonna have children. And both of these parents, Mary and Zechariah, who were from two different families, after they heard the message of the angel, the Bible says that they both sang a song to God. The Bible gives us the song of Mary and the song of Zechariah. And tonight, since we have a night of singing, let me talk to you just for a few moments about the song of Mary and the song of Zechariah. Now, I understand from the story of Christmas that the angels, right, the angels were singing. And they sang in the fields on Christmas night in Luke chapter 2, verses 13 and 14, it says, suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appear with the angels. So that's angel Gabriel came first, and then a bunch of angels came after him. And it says here, they were praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests. About 250 times in the Bible you will find this. Name for God, the Lord of hosts, Domnul Oștirilor. He's got angels who fight. These are angels of war, such as Angel Michael. He's got angels who bring messages. These are the messengers of God, such as Angel Gabriel. But the night that Jesus was born, come on, the night that Jesus was born, they didn't come to fight. They came to sing. Hallelujah. They came to teach us an important lesson about heaven. They came to teach us that God, besides angels who fight, angels who bring messages, angels who protect, God has millions of angels who sing. And as we all know from the Bible, in heaven, there's an angelic choir. Hallelujah. Here we have Mary. Here we have Zechariah. And they're singing to God, their creator. James 5:13, he says, is anyone among you happy? Second part of the verse. Because it says, if you're in trouble, you got to pray. But then it says, is anyone happy? Let him sing songs of praise. The Romanian version says, are cineva inima bună? Come on. Do you have a merry heart? Are you joyful tonight in your heart? Because that's, according to the Bible, the qualification to sing praises to God. To have peace in your heart. To have the joy of the Lord in your heart. And if you do, you qualify to sing praises to God. Mary and Zechariah sang praises to God. Revelations 15:2, it says there that when we get to heaven, it talks about the people who have conquered, the victorious ones. It says there that they held harps given to them by God. The last part of the verse, see the last phrase, they held harps given to them by God, verse 3, and they sang the song of God's servant Moses of the Lamb. So when we get to heaven, God's going to put a harp in your hand. You may not play an instrument here, but when we get to heaven, you will. Now, but again, we're still here on earth. My point is this. If you're not musically inclined, you still got to praise the Lord. Amen. If you don't play an instrument, you still got to praise the Lord. Let's look at their age. If we look at the age of Mary and the age of Zechariah, there's a big difference between the two. The Bible says that Zechariah and his wife were not old. They were very old. It says that in Luke chapter 1 and verse 7. So here's a not old, very old man. He's singing praises to God. Come on. On the other hand, we're talking about Mary. Mary was not young. Read the Bible, it's there. Mary was very young. And some people say she's too young to have a baby. So here's a very young girl and very old men. They're both singing their praises to God. Young and old, we all need to sing our praises to the Lord. Blessed be his holy name. Amen. That's what it says here. You don't have to be a certain age to sing praises to him. Very important to notice is that Mary sang her song to God before the promise of God was fulfilled in her life. On the other hand, Zechariah sang his song after the promise of God was fulfilled in his life. Listen to me. I don't know where you are in your life right now. And I don't know what promises God made to you. But if that promise had come to fruition, had come to fulfillment, you ought to sing praises to God tonight. Amen. However, if it's still to come yet, if God did not fulfill his promise to you yet, learn from the song of Mary. Mary sings before the promise of God comes. See, the angel came to both of them, gave them the promise. Mary sings before the promise comes to fulfillment. Zechariah sings after. There's always more power in the song you sing before God fulfills his promise to you. Remember the walls of Jericho? Remember the story? We're not going to go into it. You know, God asked them to shout and to sing praises when? Before or after the walls came down? Huh? Before. Because it's easy to sing after. It's easy to sing after the Lord fulfills in your life miracles that he promised to you. But oh, Mary sang before Jesus was born. He said, I believe the promise of God. So whatever God promised you, believe that the Bible says that the world will pass away, but his promises never will. He will fulfill it in your life and in my life. Heaven is a glorious place. The Bible says that no eye has seen, no ears have heard, no mind has conceived what the Lord has had prepared for us. Heaven is a place of singing. And tonight, I said a few moments before, nobody can sing your song. Nobody can sing in your place. You got to sing your own song to your Creator. Nobody can take your place. But see, it's not just about tonight. It goes deeper than that. There's a glorious day coming when Jesus Christ, the Son of God, will come again. Blessed be His holy name. And on that day, He would gather His people from the north, from the south, from the east, from the west. Every nation and every tongue, people from everywhere will be there. It will be a glorious day. And Jesus came in Bethlehem as a little baby to give you a chance to be there in heaven with Him. So I want to ask you tonight, think about this very seriously. Is your name recorded in heaven? In order for us to be there, we have to receive Him as our Lord and Savior in our lives. Make sure we follow Him with everything we have. Make sure we give Him our hearts. Amen.
They said, don't you be afraid, for this is the night of your life. There's a baby in the manger, and the whole world needs to know. It begins with you, here's what you must do. Sister.